Tonight we are checking out some diminishing rain showers. Saw some locally heavy downpours earlier tonight, and we'll take a look at some of those in just a moment. But right now, zooming in on that area, mostly out in Preble County now, some light to moderate rain from east and northeast of Eaton over towards West Alexandria, extending down through the Camden area to just north of Oxford, out towards Houston Woods State Park, and Germantown seeing some of that rain. There's the time lapse over the past hour. You can really see those intensity levels diminishing as this has been moving to the south and west. And of course, we've seen other showers up to the north as well into Miami County. Most of those have dissipated, and a couple of leftover showers around Fairborn and also out towards the Cedarville area tonight, where Dennis Lostetter picked up quite a bit of rain. We'll check out some of those rainfall totals in just a moment. But first, we want to talk about why the rain was moving from the east to the west and southwest, and that's because as we look at the upper-level wind pattern, we have a low-pressure area right here. That's where these lines are wrapped around, and we'll kind of draw that in for you, and you can see what's going on with this upper level low located to the southeast of us as we head through tomorrow and into Thursday. Our upper winds are actually coming like this around this low, so that's why that we saw that rain moving in sort of a weird direction, this low cut off from the main band of the westerlies northwest of us. And it doesn't look like it'll really get caught up with that until at the earliest sometime next week, although we will see that low gradually fill and should see a diminishing chance of rain as we head towards the end of the week and into the weekend. We had a high today of 77, 62 the low this morning, 98 the record high, 1903, and all the way down to 42 in 1898. Some wet roads tonight after the rain moved through. 63, a west wind at 5 at Dayton International, 61 on that dew point. The airport only 0.03 of an inch of rain, but Dennis Lostetter, our weather checker in Cedarville, a torrential downpour. He picked up about 1.6 inches of rain in a 45-minute time frame and then tacked on about another 1/10 of an inch after that. So a real soaker there, and of course that moved into Montgomery County, and you saw some of those rainfall totals. Centerville, over an inch of rain with this system moving through. Our weather checkers up north, Don Chateau in Sydney, reporting a mostly clear sky now, 65 degrees, 68 in Piqua. Bob Jacoby there and Nancy Davis in Pleasant Hill at 67. And a lot of our reports coming in from across Greene County, Montgomery County tonight, numerous reports there. Jim Robbins in Beaver Creek, 63 degrees and a 66 reading reported down in the Bellbrook area. Kevin Kiefer calling that in tonight. So, again, those temperatures have cooled off into the low 60s where the rain has been falling. Again, there's that low. You can really see the circulation with the clouds. Notice, though, as you get back on the west side of this, really diminishing trend there. So if this low pulls a little farther southeast tomorrow, maybe not as great a chance of rain. And we indicate that in our 7-day planner, decreasing risk of those afternoon and evening showers and thundershowers. But really not much change in our weather pattern as we roll through Wednesday and right on into Thursday. So we see those showers diminishing tonight. They'll come to an end. After midnight, only a slight chance of a shower. Overnight low around 60 degrees. Could wake up to some dense areas of fog again tomorrow morning, so watch out for that. Once again, a thunderstorm could pop up, especially in the afternoon as we climb up into the 70s. 67 10 o'clock, 75 at 2, and 77 at 4 p.m. And anytime you want to check out live Doppler 2X tomorrow, watch that rain pop up again. It's there at WDTN.com. Your 7-day planner there is that diminishing chance of rain for Thursday and into Friday. And just in time for the weekend. That's what everybody wants to see. So for the USC Ohio State game, folks heading over there, looks like it should be a great evening to tailgate.